Welcome back to the Middle Earth Shadow of War, Blade of Galadriel walkthrough part 2, Gravewalker difficulty walkthrough part 11, where we will conquer all of the Saragost missions for Blade of Galadriel, including getting all of the loots and whatever quests they want us to do in Saragost. Time to take down Ice Mountain. Not sure what to expect with this guy, but as with all of the captains that we face one-on-one, we'll look for his weaknesses and try and exploit those.
Oh, that cold mountain air really makes you feel alive, doesn't it? That feeling will pass.
Not immune to arrows nor light, so we will use those two. Next up is the blizzard, and let's find out what his weaknesses are.
I came here for adventure! To test myself against the elements! I've gone to Mirkwood if I wanted to dance with some feeble elf!
It'd be nice if I could execute. Thing he's vulnerable to is frost and curse. Oh, but he's enraged by frost, so that wouldn't do any good. So curse and execute, neither of which I have. This should be fun.
Let's go!
Too bad. Next up will be the chill.
I'm done with meat. I'm done with feasting and drink. outlaw seeks simpler pleasures. Testing myself against an unforgiving land. Hunting beasts and, oh yes, killing elves.
Fantastic, he has softed it. Let's do the shiver next, see what we can get for the bow.
Elf girl! You're no blade, you're just a runner! A coward!
The shiver should be conceptually a little bit more difficult than the last three guys were. Well, let's find out.
I thought I'd experienced every pleasure there was. But this place, the air, the dizzying heights, make me tingle! Or maybe you're causing that!
He can be damaged by light, but he's immune to execute, so I'm going to swap back over to my other dagger so that I can attack him with the light bolt.
Oh,
think he's going to be coming back. Alright, let's see what makes this guy so special.
Because I was bored everywhere else, with the looting, the drinking, the marauding. But what do I find? An elf! Your kind is as boring as it gets.
Stealth attacks would work, but fire's not doing a whole lot of damage to him. This guy's tough. Thank you. That was a total pain in the ass. Right, last piece of loot to get in Saragos. You probably want to have the Serpent Tamer gear first, but what the hell, let's do it anyway.
Saragos is beautiful in its way. Endless fields of stark white ice and snow. What a lovely place for you to be buried.
Good, fear of pinning. But he's frostproof, so at least we'll get a daze on him. Yep, so daze with pinning and then take him out with melee attacks, it looks like.
Do the elves face in Mordor? The tribes, ordered and regimented, an abomination. The perfect state of Orcdom is chaos. That is where our strength lies. Tribes are an attempt to impose order where there should be none. It cuts us down as surely as an elven blade.
How many like me have you sent to Mordor?
None like you. You are unique in what you have accomplished, and in that I expect you to return.
wasn't too bad. All you have to really do is parry.
Duo. Two followers for the price of one.
I'm told they're rather excitable.
Time to recruit.
Some orcs have simple pleasures. These two have a love for all that is loud and explosive. Use this knowledge to draw them out and secure their loyalty.
Tinder, did you hear it? It was Boots! Glorious Boots! Who did this? Come on! Let's make things go boom together!
I am Altariel, the Blade of...
You make awesome Boots! We have to work together! In fact, we could use your skills for a project we've been working on! If you help us, we'll owe you one! There will be Boots!
How could I say no to such an enthusiastic invitation?
Good! Yes, good! Me and my blood brother here have a problem with something that lives in the caves nearby. And it always ruins our fight! Whenever we try to reach new levels of boom, it shows up and puts out all the fires! We wanna break it and make it our own! In fact, we'll make a game of it! Whoever makes the most booms in the process wins! Remember, don't kill the beast. We just want to break it. We start on boom.
Boom?
3, 2, 1, boom. Boom! That was amazing! My ears are still ringing, and I've been nearly deaf for years! As for this beast, you'll be singing it again real soon. Oh, the sweet booms it'll make!
You're one of us now. Anytime you need something to go boom, just ask. And we won't take no for an answer.
I'm honored.
No, no, no.
We're honored.
Such base orcs. But allies are few and far between in Mordor.
I just hope my ears stop ringing soon. If this fortress can't be taken, I'll destroy it.
Either way, it will weaken our enemies.
And once again, we'll figure out the strategy as we go along.
One word. Barrels.
You're correct. That is one word.
They're all over the place. Normally, you poison a barrel. It's good for a couple dead orcs. But use this poison, and you'll render the entire fortress uninhabitable. Lousy globs don't even need to drink it. Then again, there's one glob in there who owes me a favor. I've got to get him out, or I'll catch up with you later.
Now we shall see how effective his solutions are, and perhaps why he is providing them.
Ha ha! Another abomination cleansed from Mordor.
Word of advice. You might want to back away from the poisonous green fog. Once you get the rest of the barrels poisoned, all the orcs in here will have to flee. Or die.
Sounds like you have everything planned out.
Except for that glob I need to rescue. He's too well guarded. Could use a hand getting him out of here, if you're inclined. Should do it for this end. Ah, that will be Flint Tinder. There he is.
Now, this is what I call helping.
Ah.
Couldn't have posted me someplace warmer. Someplace I could wear my clothes.
All the barrels in the outer wall. Time to head further into the fortress.
What the bloody shrock is going on out here? Why is there poison everywhere? You! She-elf! Oh, I hope you had fun, because now I'm gonna tear you apart!
Safe distance, and signal me when you're clear. Or place archers will blow up the barrels. No one's ever setting foot in this fortress again.
Hmm.
Another fortress taken from the Flaming Eye, and done so without an army.
But the Gravewalker does have an army, and you will have to face him.
My lady, I have searched every corner of Mordor for you. Ever since I first heard the stories of an elf that burned with the brightness of a sun, I never imagined you would be so enchanting.
Oh.
I hereby renounce the dominion of the Dark Lord, the Bright Lord, whatever that cursed eye atop Barad-dûr is. I pledge myself here and now to you.
Much better. We finally have a bodyguard. It's pretty good. The only thing it looks like he needs to worry about is cursed enemies. And as with the other two zones, I think we'll go ahead and get all of the gear first before moving on with the story missions. We're ready for our first mission in Nurgle, but I think we're going to break here. I'll upload this video and then we'll move on to the next one. Hope you guys like episode 2 or 11, whichever way you look at it, and we'll be back shortly for the next one.